Mike Papantonio. He's the attorney with and partner with Love and Law and co-host of Ring of Fire Radio with Bobby Kennedy Jr. and Sam Cedar. RingofFireRadio.com, of course, their website. And, Pap, welcome back to the program.
Tom, how are you?
I am great, but I'll get better, my friend. And you?
Doing fine, thanks.
Good, good. I'm just astounded by the fact that 25% of the Republicans polled in this public policy poll that was commissioned by Daily Kos, 25% of Republicans want their state to leave the United States.
Right.
You know, I'm guessing you've got a take on this.
Well, I do. You know, this is something the Republicans are desperately trying to run away from, is this whole secession idea. This week we see, and it's going to continue, removing the right-wing Republicans from committees, trying to bring some normalcy back to this party. But when you have something like the secession issue out there, it's very difficult to accomplish that, Tom. You have credible conservative newspapers that are trying to suggest, well, this is really nothing. This is just a handful of wing nuts that are out there trying to accomplish this. And it's a problem because I guess for the Republicans right now, they've identified the idea that if they don't just completely rebuild, their chances of extinction are very, very high. So you see this infighting, like we saw with, you know, can you imagine Republican senators attacking Bob Dole, who's up talking about, talking
about in a wheelchair.
So what they're trying to do is you have people with a brain, you have rational thinkers within the Republican Party trying to say we have to do something. Now, the secession problem is a big problem because out in Texas, the conservative newspapers, they want to say, well, you know, gee, this isn't really that big of a deal, but it is a big deal.
Yeah, it definitely is. And 38 Republicans.
Yes.
Including Jim DeMint, Mike Lee, Marco Rubio, right, voted to say that they're not going to go along with the UN treaty that simply mirrors existing American law that was signed into place by George W. Bush. Is it possible that these Republicans in the Senate, this is the Americans with Disability Act, the UN's
right,
decided
right,
this is such a great idea, why don't we go international with it and simply, you know, take the American law and make it a UN treaty. And, you know, it wouldn't have changed the American law at all. Treaties become the law of the land, but we already have it as a law. And, I mean, was this Republicans voting? Rick Santorum got up and said, you know, this is going to lead to abortions or something like that. Never did make sense to me. But is this Republicans just, you know, opposed the Americans with Disabilities Act, and therefore they don't want to see it as a treaty because that makes it more permanent? Or is this just, you know, hey, we are still opposing anything this administration wants.
It is that we are still obstructionist. And here's why, Tom. There's this nightmarish thing. It's a nightmarish fish called a snakehead fish. Now, the reason I tell you this story is because the snakehead fish is the equivalent of the Tea Party. It's what's happening to the Republican Party. The snakehead fish is this sharp, has this sharp, shark-like teeth. Yeah, 75,000 eggs it lays a year. It eats virtually everything. It drinks blood. It destroys everything within its reach. The problem is that is what the Tea Party has become to the Republican Party. Now, some people understand the importance of killing the snakehead fish. Others still don't get it. Eric Cantor still doesn't get it. Rubio still doesn't get it. But the people who are rational thinkers are understanding when we have issues like we saw the attack on this very, very distinguished politician and great statesman, Bob Dole, when we see secession being talked about in our red states like Texas and Georgia and Alabama, what it is the snakehead fish is out of control. And that's right now, in the next few weeks, Tom, you're going to see Republicans quietly removing wingnut, really ultra-conservative Republicans from important committees. You're going to see them trying to quietly remove very, right now, influential wingnut right-wing Republicans from party leadership. It's going to happen behind closed doors. We'll probably start seeing the stories next month more than ever. But there's some intelligence, some rational thinking within the Republican Party that says if we don't do this, we will become extinct because the snakehead fish is eating us up.
So Bruce Bartlett might end up replacing Karl Rove on Fox News on the official, you know, on GOP TV.
Well, isn't that a great example? Isn't that a wonderful example? Listen, when Roger Ailes says something ails Fox News, and he says we have to have the little turd blossom moved aside, we have to have crazy man Dick Morris moved aside, because it simply is not projecting what we're going to have to project for the Republican Party this next year and the year after that in order to have a chance.
Well, I thought it was really interesting. I don't know if you saw this. I get the trade publications for the talk radio industry, and I don't remember if it was in Talkers or if it was in one of the other ones. But you know, you get a daily email blast. And 3 or 4 days ago, Michael Savage wrote this long op-ed piece, or they quoted him in an interview in one of the radio trades, and this went out to every talk show host in America, saying that if right-wing talk show hosts think that they're going to hold their audience simply by bashing Obama, They're nuts. That it's just not, it doesn't play with the American people anymore.
Yeah. Well, that's exactly
that's
right.
Michael Savage. I mean, you
know, well, it is. I mean, to have him saying that, I think what Savage is seeing for a long time, Tom, what the American public and advertisers and people who run these radio stations have been completely fleeced by the Michael Savages and the Rush Limbaughs. For example, Rush Limbaugh has always tried to project that he has this huge, huge audience. He did it one time. But that audience is disappearing because of the things we always talk about, because of demographics change, because of generational changes. But at the same time, they're disappearing because rational thinkers still do occupy the position of Republican voters. Mm. And Republican voters are saying the snakehead fish is eating us up, and if we don't do something about it, we're going to be yesterday's news.
And yet, in the minute we have left here, Pep, Boehner's got a real problem, because he's got Eric Cantor, who is in with the Tea Party guys, standing right behind him, the number two guy with a shiv stuck in his left kidney.
Well, exactly right. And he realizes that Cantor now is positioning for a position in 2016.
Right.
And he understands that Cantor represents the divide. Rubio represents the divide. And they're at a loss for trying to find something that fits into that middle that can again make a Republican proud to be Republican instead of being embarrassed.
Although Rubio did come out today and say that the world is 4.5 billion years old.
Yes. Well, so. What he really said, I think the quote was, "Yes, I know how old the Earth is." And then when he was pressed, he actually came up with the number.
Yeah. But according to science.
Yeah. According to science.
Yeah.